Thank you. John, JR, a little bit reality show like TYT.com/join and enjoy this.
You know what you're seeing behind me, Jersey? Hold. Watch me flip this camera. Right, flip it. Do I flip it like this? No, I just took a picture. I'm bitsing right now.
What?
Behind the scenes.
Okay. Remembers? I don't have my face on.
She doesn't have her face on, folks. Oh, that's JR's ass right there.
You can't take 5 minutes off, can you?
No, I can't, Johnny. Bye.
I said it was live stream, but I was lying. It's not a live stream. It's just for members.
Bitsy, this is my cat. You know what his name is? Kiki Cat.
Animals are innocent.
Control room and the insanity is obviously there.
Right, as you can.
If you're frantically tweeting at us that something's broken, thank you, because I'm fixing it.
And thank you for being a TYT member.
Super last thing.
There's always got to be a super last thing.
Oh, that was disastrous.
This has been Behind the Scenes, Behind the Scenes.
Welcome to Indisputable. I'm your host, Dr. Rashad Richard. We got a lot happening today. But what do we do on this show? We tell the truth. You know why we tell the truth? Because the truth is simply indisputable.
Rashad, great to be here. Congratulations on the new show. And I got to let everybody know that Rashad and I go way back.
Here's the pattern that we see in all of these Karen stories. They think they own stuff they do not own. Now, where does that come from? I don't know. Maybe slavery. Maybe they think they should still own black people.
This is what happens when Karens weaponize the police.
When you're used to privilege, equality seems like oppression.
It hits you in a certain way when someone is holding you against your will, treating you like you're a criminal and you're an innocent person. This is something that black people face no matter where they are.
A stronger black economy lends itself to a stronger, greater economy. Don't think it's exclusive of you, it's inclusive of you.
What's your beef with critical race theory?
It adds more fuel to the fire of the racist tendencies that we already have.
We have a generation of problem solvers that can remedy the problem if they are properly taught what the problem is.
You know who created redlining in this country? The white liberal.
I don't give a damn who created it. If it's a racist policy, Shelly, here's what I don't know. I don't know. See, there you go filibustering, brother. You're scared of this truth, but you're going to get it, though.
Climate is changing fundamentally, extremely, and non-linearly. It's becoming worse now. It's not when the levees burst that is the problem. It's in the anticipation of that.
So I hope every human being is safe. And by human beings, I do not include multinational corporations, especially the ones that started climate change in the first place.
What we're currently doing right now in cutting emissions is clearly not enough. There will be ramifications to what Trump is doing. I don't want people to suffer, but I feel like there's going to be a lot of suffering because we have an imbecile as our leader.
Okay, back in the bonus episode, Cenk and Anna with you guys. Just real cute, real quick cutie story about being pro. Yesterday we had the TYT draft. It involves a lot of the folks that work here, but also some folks who aren't here anymore. But the Vigs in the TYT draft, Emma Biglin still participates, former champion, like not a two-time champion like me. Anyways, this year I had Pro help me draft, and he was so excited. Okay, and I said, look, I'm not gonna pull a Michael Schur. Michael would have his son help him draft, like when the kid was like seven or whatever, and he'd be like, hey buddy, who do you want to pick? And I was like, no, don't do it, don't do it. He's gonna pick a kicker in the first round. Don't do it, right? Okay, so with Pro, I was messing with him. He's 12, right? And he knows football inside and out. And I'm like, all right, buddy, who do you want to pick?
Why you guys gonna talk to your kids like that?
Okay, but I'm messing with him though. And if he was gonna pick people I didn't like, I was like, I'm not gonna do it. Okay. And I was like, like he was like, oh, okay, I really want to pick that guy. I'm like, no. but a bunch of times, half the team, I was like, all right, I wouldn't pick that guy, but let's see what you got, buddy. Okay. So if he
did he make you proud?
Yeah, no, he drafted perfectly well. I love my team, so it's good. And he can't wait to make trades. He's been thinking about trades all night long. Oh, I love this kid. Okay. So
it's great that you guys are teaching your sons to be, involved in fantasy. It's good. It's a good thing.
Oh, let alone me and Ben teaching him gambling.
No,
tons and tons of people watch sports and never gamble.
Here's the problem, team. Nobody knows what Hulu Plus Live TV is.
Yeah, it comes with over 75 live channels with sports like NFL games, plus Hulu's entire streaming library.
Plus Disney Plus, plus ESPN Plus.
What if we change the name?
Give me something. No bad ideas. Let's go.
Super Hulu.
Bad idea.
Hulu Bold.
No.
Hulu Plus Live TV Plus.
Yeah, everybody's kind of doing the plus thing after the name.
What if we call it Hulu Plus Live TV Plus Plus Plus?
You say.
You watch the game. Are you not entertained? You got something out of it. And yeah, I get that you like your favorite team, but like, they're not going to win every time. Like, the idea of allowing it to ruin your day, I think, is almost clinically insane.
Okay, you are like, you are like, I've never seen anyone understand sports less. Okay.
No.
And I get it. I get it. We're crazy, right? And like, you're like, well, rationally, you know that your team's not going to win every time, so I don't know why you would be upset about it. Yeah, rationally. No, by the way, it's in our DNA, you know, to both participate in play, but also be interested in play, and for males to be more aggressively interested in play. And that is what all sports is, right? So should we be upset about it all day? Of course not. But is it fun? Yeah, of course. And if you're not that emotionally invested in it, it's less fun. And so, and of course, I know everybody's wondering, who's your favorite Bundesliga team? And to that I say, Ost Deutschland.
Is that a team?
No, that's the chant of the Dresden team. And I know I don't care about the Dresden team, and no, I don't want to chant scary German chants. I'm just referring to an old school episode where we made fun of that chant. Slash.
What? I know that there are already people upset at me. I just got word that there are people heated over my comments here. Don't let me get to you. That's also clinically insane. Okay. But no, let me also kind of pour salt on that wound a little bit. The other thing that gets to me about the spectators is when they're like yelling at the athletes because the athletes aren't performing well enough for them, And it's like, have you looked at yourself? Like, you know, like, are you really the right person to critique these professional athletes and how they're performing? Athletes do is incredible. The reason why they're professional athletes is because they're able to do what they do. So, like, to have people in the audience screaming at them for not being good enough or whatever, I just simmer down. Simmer down a little bit. How about that?
Nope. Disagree to disagree. Okay, they're bums and they ought to do better. They're letting us down.
All right. It's so good. They really nailed it. I will give them that. Okay?
All right.
Let's talk about horses. Horses are in the news today. So, an upcoming book by a New York Times reporter by the name of David Enrich alleges that Donald Trump once tried to pay his lawyer not with currency of any sort. He wanted to pay his lawyer with a horse. Because of course. Now, Trump offered to pay the lawyer, whom he owed $2 million, the deed to a stallion. Enrich reported in Servants of the Damned, Giant Law Firms, Donald Trump, and the Corruption of Justice, out next week. Now, he writes in the book that Trump made some apologetic noises and said, quote, "I'm not going to pay your bill. I'm going to give you something more valuable." I'm sure every lawyer wants to hear that. I'm not going to pay your bill. I'm going to give you something better. Now, Trump wasn't horsing around. The former president then rummaged around in the filing cabinet and pulled out a deed to a horse supposedly worth $5 million. Now, we'll get to whether or not that even exists, horses that cost $5 million. I'm not a horse expert, but we do have a horse expert working with us, and she helped me out with this story, Ishwari. Now, the lawyer was not impressed with this offer. Once he regained the capacity for speech, the lawyer reportedly said, quote, "This isn't the 1800s. You can't pay me with a horse." And after the lawyer threatened to sue, Trump eventually paid at least a portion of what he owed, which is better than the huge for the former president, who is known for bilking his lawyers and others who, should get paid.
Okay, the guy is hilarious. I mean, who pays with a horse? Who pays with a horse? Hey, so...
I might take that offer.
No. You should... first of all, never take an offer from Trump. Ever. Okay? So, today Tucker Carlson was calling John Fetterman a deadbeat. Have you ever seen a bigger deadbeat than Donald Trump? But like... literally, he might be the biggest deadbeat in American history. He never, ever pays his bills. You know that the Republican National Committee very recently said, yeah, look, we're going to stop paying your legal fees. Because he got a couple $100 million to pay for legal fees. And he won't use the money because he's trying to figure out how to steal it. But he won't use it for legal fees. So he's like, I'm not paying. And then Republicans have to use other money to pay for his legal fees. He's unbelievable. Like, massacred his reputation on live television to support Donald Trump. You get like a Harry Carey on his own reputation. He's like, oh, I will be a moron. And Trump's like, no, I'm not paying the legal fees. He's like, well, I'm going to go to jail. What are you doing? You have come $100 million and you gave me for that. He's like, nope, I'm not paying the fees. I love it. I love people who are stupid enough to give Donald Trump money. And so, by the way, you know what? He has those... negligent lawyers now who are like, I answer you. Walk in all the time. Like, these are random people who walk in that office, right? Like, implicating him 100%. Why? Because he never pays his lawyers. So no lawyer will take the case anymore. Even though he's a former president, it would be amazing. But they're like, I don't want to get paid in a horse. Okay? And if you said yes, you think he'd send you the $5 million horse? No. He'd send you a donkey or a mule. Trust me, it's a $5 million horse. It's the best horse you you've ever seen. Okay. He's just a life form.
Like Donald Trump, who tries to literally pay his lawyers with horses, if they're lucky enough, by the way, to even get any kind of payment from Donald Trump. All right, so let's talk about whether there's ever a possibility for a horse to be worth $5 million. I think horses are great. I like to think of them as big dogs, and I love dogs. I didn't think that any of them would ever be worth $5 million, but I was mistaken. Okay, so apparently they can be worth $5 million, and in fact, much more. Factors such as breed, age, performance level, and capability influence the horse's price. Thus, racehorses fetch a higher price due to the potential earnings they may earn in the future. So if it's a, like, badass racehorse, and you're gonna race it for money, then it could be valuable, it could be worth $5 million or more. In fact, apparently there are, this is insane, there are some horses, is this correct, that are worth as much as, where did I read that? I thought I read somewhere that there are some, yeah, here we go. Get a load of this and sit down, so you can really take this in, because this blows my mind. The most expensive horse of all time, a thoroughbred, with a name I'm not going to try to pronounce, I can say Pegasus, sold at a whopping $70 million. $70 million. Another famous one, the retired British champion Frankel, was once valued at over $100 million. Now, do we think that Trump was in possession of that kind of a horse? I doubt it. But who knows?
I know that he was in possession of a horse's ass. And that's him. I'm surprised, being the mob boss that he is, or mob boss wannabe that he is, that he didn't offer to pay with a horse's head. But look, if he thinks every single person who gives him money or does any goods or services for him is a sucker to be robbed, if you're a voter of his, what do you think he thinks of you?
Let's compare those fancy horses I just talked about with Turkish horses. Okay. You ready for that? Remember, we just talked about a $70 million horse. We talked about a $100 million horse. There are apparently Turkish horses as well, and British horses. So a British and American bred trained racehorse, Sharif Dancer, has an impressive net worth of $40 million. Throughout his career, the stallion has won 3 races and was placed 2nd in 1, making him the most successful racehorses in history, one of the most successful racehorses in history. Now, the list goes on, with many around the world priced at millions. Arabian and English horses easily get those fancy price tags, but Turkey, according to Aishwarya, who helped us research for this, says that Turkey is not that far behind, but I disagree. The Golden Akal Teke is a very rare Turkish horse and is considered the best naturally golden-colored horse on earth, but they cost around $100,000 on average. Sorry, Cenk. Turkey's not bringing the best horses, okay? They're trying.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. Look, first of all, we have the golden horses, okay? And look, to all my creditors, I am very happy to pay you with this horse. Okay, look, it might not be money, but it's golden. It's golden.
Golden horse.
We should go back to the golden horse standard. You know, the Federal Reserve is a mess. We're not winning with it. Let's go back to golden horses standard.
Yep. Yeah. All right. Well, we've got one more story for you that will blow your mind, because there are man children out there, and we're going to give you an example of one. What you just watched was a grown-ass man stealing a baseball that was intentionally pitched, meaning thrown, toward a little girl who was about to catch it until it was you know, intercepted by a grown-ass man who wanted the ball for himself. So the video is from the Nationals Nationals versus A's game on September 1st. And this video is obviously going viral now for the reasons that I expressed earlier. September 1st was also Youth Champions Day. And so the Nationals invited I don't know how to pronounce that. Shenandoah? Rec League? God, I mess up these sports stories so bad. The point is, there was an adult who stole a ball from a kid and didn't give it back. That's it. That's all you need to know. That's the story. You don't need to know all the minute details of it, okay? That happened.
Who did the VS play? Now, you figured out it was versus.
You shut up.
Who figured it out? Okay. Anyway... I think our coverage of the story is funnier than the story itself. Okay. Anyways, look, when I first read the headline on the story, I thought that the somebody had hit it into the stands. And so those balls can come pretty fast. So I thought the guy maybe snagged the ball so that it didn't hit the little girl. Then, of course, he handed the ball back to her, but people were making a federal case out of it. No, the player was pitching the ball lightly to the girl in specific. She had a glove on. As Anna said, a grown-ass man comes and goes, "That's mine!" Okay? Takes it. I can't believe he didn't give it back to her. I can't believe he didn't give it back. And he just, I got him! How do you tell the story? Like, what's cool about getting a ball at the ballpark is, like, telling the story. I once caught a ball when I was a kid, right? And I brought my glove because I was a child.
I am the benevolent dictator for life.
And I loved it, and I told all my friends the story. How do you do it? So this guy's pitching the ball to this little girl. And I think, oh, yeah, little girl, you're not getting it. I'm getting it. Ha, ha. And are his friends like, attaboy? You VS the girl? You won? Okay.
Why aren't women getting married anymore? So many quality men out there. What's going on? No, come on. Look, I don't know who this guy is. I hope he feels deep shame. Like, there's got to be some humanity in that man. Like, how do you do that? So, by the way, the Washington Nationals reached out to the little girl and her mom. So I want to share that exchange with you. So a woman named Gina Hillard posted the video on Twitter claiming the little girl is her daughter. And at that point, the Nationals Twitter account responded saying, "Hey, Gina, mind giving us a follow and we'll send you a DM," right? And they did that. She responds, "Thank you, Nationals, for reaching out and apologizing to hear that our experience that night was negatively impacted. They are sending something our way and hope this can serve as a symbol of a good experience at the park rather than a bad one." So the Nationals wanted to make it right, and it's really sweet of them to want to do that. But can I just, not to add insult to injury, but can I just give you the name of the softball team that was there at the event? It's the Shenandoah Rec League Babe Ruth 10U All-Star Softball Team. You got to do something about that. Like, you got to do something. What is that? That's
it's too long. It's unacceptable.
Okay. So, like, don't get mad at me that I, like, flubbed when I was trying to tell you about the softball team that was there. Okay.
Yeah. No, I got you. You got to come up with a better name, man. And you got to make it something that's relevant to your area. Like, so my fantasy football nickname for a long time in the TYT league was The Conversation. Okay. Perfect. So, see, that makes sense. Easy, logical. There you go. All right. So, but last thing here. First of all, the Nationals don't have anything to apologize for. They were all trying to do the right thing. But it's really great of them to reach out. They found out 5 days later. See, look, here's a story that goes viral, but has a positive ending. So, hey, social media led to something positive for once. God bless. Now, by the way, don't ruin it, guys, by doing like an international manhunt for the guy. Like, everybody's like, "Who's the guy? Let's find him." No, don't find him. Just, okay, let him feel his shame at home. You don't have to throw tomatoes at him and have him walk down through the Red Keep, okay? Just Leave it alone.
Shame.
See, we just did it. So it's all good. She's going to get the ball. Everybody's happy. I can't hear you, Anna.
I don't know why that happens. I didn't even mute myself. It just sometimes mutes on its own. Anyway, no, I was just going to say, there's like always some sort of drama with these like ball stories. I feel like this is, or, oh, it's a big sporting event and some guy thought it would be super cute to do a very public proposal. And then it turns out that the girl says no. Like there's always some drama, some soap opera type drama at these sporting events. It's kind of fun. I kind of like it. It makes sports a lot more interesting.
Okay, I just want to know for the record that it sounded like Anna said in the beginning of that. There's always some sort of drama with these ball stories. Whenever there's balls, there's always drama. Well, what's with guys and their balls and the drama?
Okay. Well, that too, actually.
Well, that too. That's true.
Reality shows are all about.
Speaking of which, we're past 5:20, which means that there's balls happening over there on the... Because that means da-da-da-da, and football is okay. All right, guys, we're out of time. We're going to end 2 minutes early here in honor of the NFL kickoff. We love you guys. That's why we're going to do a whole other show tomorrow. Can you believe it? All right, Casper, much love. Here we go. Bye-bye.
We've never been so black. Yeah, I don't want to show my face this episode. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that sounds like something she would say, too. Another one? What the? And I kind of think, you know, correct me if I'm wrong, but it's probably, like, is there any basis? Like, did they have something that they were wronged and they felt, like, they just retaliated?
The paradigm of absolute control.
Damn.
That's why we're just out here doing simple things, pointing out that we're meant to be in nature and be natural, and this is where we find the source that God made to transcend the new
world. Yeah.
And that's why they want to try to keep us out of it.
That's not good.
Wow, we're on Verizon now.
Yes, Cecily, because of their...
Hmm. Yeah, well, that's interesting. Hey, Barth Eater. Nina's saying that she can't hear you. Audio problem. Thanks, Nina.
I'll bet you can hear me now, though, right?
Oh, we got six viewers.
Hey, six viewers. Hey, well, two of them are me.
I think I'm also two of them. I think I'm also two of them.
That's cool. It's all that counts, really. It's really all that counts. So it's like you go to like Walmart, you go to get some ammo for your ammo shooter, and they're gonna say like, oh hey, yeah, you want to buy some 9mm? Great. Boop. Okay, let's see your ID. Boop. Run your ID. And it says, oh hey, we don't have you registered for 9mm. You have a 9mm that we don't know about. So then what you would have to do is you would have to take your 9mm and take it to like one of the registered places that are registered these days. I don't know what they call them. There's a technical three-letter acronym for it.
It was the sheriff's office.
Well, no. It's all company. It's all like, so say you want to buy somebody's gun from somebody in Nevada or some other state. Right. So they send it to a broker that they send it to these guys and they run it and you get it from them and they charge you a fee to do that. Okay, so you go to those same guy, that same company. It's going to be a gun store. So you go to the gun store, the big gun store, and you, the specialty gun store, not the sporting good. Maybe Dick's would do it. But there's a really important component to what I'm about to propose, and that is that. What would happen? See, I'm only showing three viewers. Oh no, I'm showing six viewers.
Yeah.
So
I saw six. So, yeah, I see six right now.
Right on. So what I would propose is that so if you want to buy ammunition for a something that you legally own, you first have to take it to a gun store. One that can do this. So what they would do is they would say, okay, so you own you own an M6, you own an M16 or an AK or a. Let's start there. Let's start with assault with quote assault weapons unquote. Although that's a silly phrase. It's real. There's really no. I have no. It's really just a silly phrase. All weapons are assault weapons. Just because it has fancy garbage attached to it doesn't make it an assault weapon.
Well, okay, but Barkeeter, like, from my viewpoint, like yeah, all weapons could kill, but you know, like assault weapons compared to like pistols, they like pistols
that's
could only fire
yeah,
like
that's no, it's a different class of weapon. Yeah, a handgun you own, you have a, like a one to two rounds per second firing rate, whereas something with a bump with a M16 with a bump stock on it, with AR-15 with a bump stock, you know, you're ripping off a few more than that.
Like,
so, yeah, no, I'm totally right. No, I know what you mean.
I wonder if but we have any Call of Duty viewers on there. Right.
But yeah, no. I mean, you're gonna, yeah. Rate of fire is different. The load size, you know, you have so many difference. You know, you're not gonna use a handgun at 100 yards.
Hmm. No. Yeah, that's a far distance. That's like a whole football field. That's half a football field.
Yeah.
Isn't that half of it?
But I prefer snipers. But I'm a decent shot, so I know how to take a shot, and I'm I go with that. So.
Yeah.
I stay in practice. I like trap shooting. You know, shooting a 12 gauge at clay pigeons. I think that's pretty fun.
I've had a BB gun before, and I had like a P90 BB gun.
Those are like a 22.
Oh, what's a 22? It's a pistol?
No, it's a round. It's not a. I mean, but it's just you can. They have them in rifles and pistols.
Hmm.
It's just a caliber.
Oh, and
but I like 22 long rifle in a rifle. Those it's fun.
Like caliber is like how much it penetrates or no. Like the power of the bullet.
No, it's the size of the barrel.
Oh.
It's the size of the barrel hole.
Oh.
It's the size of the bullet that's supposed to travel through the barrel hole, more specifically. But they're pretty close. The barrel hole's a little bit bigger than the round.
Yes.
There's some rounds that you can chamber different. I don't know details, but like probably like but there's like several fairly kind of compatible rounds. Like you can go down a size, but you can't go up.
I wanted to kind of piggyback off of like what Nina talked about when she went on.
Let me finish my thought real quick, because I'm not done with that. We were all just talking. We got kind of sidetracked a little bit. All right. So what I propose is you take if you need ammo for a gun that you haven't gotten ammo for yet. Since the rules change, you'd have to take that. You'd have to take that to a store, right? And they would have to verify that it has a serial number on it. They wouldn't record it. Okay.
Actually,
you'd have to. No, I take that back. You're recording the state's gonna hold the record. not the feds. Just like your driver's license, the state holds the record, not the feds. And then, but the feds would provide a database, would provide the clearinghouse of information that would determine whether you're okay to, so in other words, whether you're okay to have anything regarding
firearms. Well, wouldn't the police department, they could petition the state with all of their union power, which we know,
there's a technicality. Hang on, hold that tangent. Because I still have, I gotta finish this. So I'm reminded of Vivaldi again, okay, and how kids have access to firearms. So what's going to end up happening is that you take your firearm to the store, right? And if it's too old, if it's an antique, they're not going to mess with it. If it's an AK or if it's an AR-15, if it's something fancy, you've got to put either a ring lock or a fingerprint lock on it. It's got to be retrofitted. It's got to be retrofitted, or you have to have a lower. You have to have a replacement lower.
Well, retrofitting means like it has to be like you're talking about an actual ring that goes on your finger, like a friendship ring, a marriage ring.
Yeah.
Okay, and then that so then the firearm could only be used if it is if you have the ring on you, if it has like the track, the whatever, the identifier.
Yep.
Identifying technology from the ring, yeah,
like an RFID or something like that.
Yeah,
I kind of would prefer fingerprint though, because you can steal. A kid could steal a ring wedding band. No, I'm. Yeah, it would be the wrong hand. For most people, it would be the wrong hand. We're trained to use our right hand, whether you're left-handed or not. But that's why I would rather go with fingerprint. So as you, like, for a handgun, as you're holding a handgun, you have you could use your thumbprint, or maybe it'll be like a two-finger deal. Like, one is a trigger and one is a... One is a fingerprint reader and one is a trigger or something like that. Okay.
Huh.
All right. My audio is a lot lower. Okay. Let's see what I can do here.
Oh, my bad. I'm like multitasking. Oh, Vightingale's on here.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah. Vightingale's giving me audio. Audio heads up. Let me get the mic closer to me to start with. Let me look over here and see what we got. Okay, that's all the way up. Do I have any other adjustment? Let's see. I don't think I have any more adjustments. I have not.
Let's go over there.
That may be. Let me click this button, and let's see if there's any knobs or anything I can tweak down here.
Thanks for watching, thanks for swinging by at least.
Yeah, really. It's like 7 viewers really pushes the month's average up.
Yeah, our goal is to have 3 viewers. So.
Yeah, we're out to get an affiliate, hit our affiliate goal, and bootstrap other groups. Like any place I can lurk and support anybody by lurking, then I'll lurk. I now have the bandwidth. I was in a bandwidth like last year I had a megabit per second on HughesNet, and then all of a sudden I had Starlink, and then we got cable. So I have redundant internet. So I get to play. I was actually an early adopter of the internet. I was a bulletin board operator back in the late 80s and early 90s, and helping people connect over various subject matters over FidoNet. And so I got on the internet early. I was an early adopter in Denver on the NICS, the NICS bulletin board system. Don't interrupt me, damn it! What?
They still have the internet relay chat.
Oh yeah.
You know, FreeNode, IRC.
Yeah, FreeNet. Yep. Oh yeah, all of those old IRC networks are still going, and it's been a couple months since I've had an IRC client. I've been kind of ignoring my IRC community lately, and I really should. Now that I have a stable internet connection, you know, that's something that I should investigate again, being able to do stuff like that. I don't know if I would run an, I don't know if I'd run an IRC server. Actually, I would run an IRC server, but it wouldn't be connected to anything. But yeah. Yeah, it'd be a standalone, because IRC is cool. It's really neat to see that I can do like stuff like I got wrong keyboard.
Like you could sign into IRC anonymously, can't you? But oh no, I've used the quote before, but to set up Tor on that was difficult for me.
Yeah, it's kind of like technically complicated, an IRC server, especially when if you're connecting to a network of IRC servers. But I like using the slash me command is something that I've been using for, wow, 30 years. Probably since 95 or so.
Yeah.
1990. I've probably used a slash me command. Try it. I just used it. I just used it in the Twitch chat.
Oh, I'm making food right now, so I really don't know what I'm making, but I'm making food.
It's foodie. He's a foodie. That LM is right on.
Yeah. No, but I had the meeting with the tenant organization right after work, so I wasn't able to get anything to eat. I was just like, you know, and you know, we're talking about ways to protect your privacy, and also, but like, you know, me making food and stuff, like having food after a tenant organization meeting after work is also a way to struggle. So for those of us that are in the struggle, we need to be privacy minded and make sure that we take these measures to, you know, I don't know, I find it important to always go over that, like, even though people are, you know, there's some awareness about it, but still, like, I'm that kind of person, like, let's go over the fundamentals. Let's go over the basics and prevent losses and liabilities, stuff like that. Like, because we don't want people in the progressive arm we don't want people in the progressive movement to get like you know, we don't want them to get doxxed and stuff when they put out articles like for example what the lady did with the Pandora Papers, right? With that journalist, like, I don't know. I don't think she was doxxed, but, you know, she did some pretty important work reporting on, you know, how the wealthiest, the billionaires of each country, except for the United States, hide their money. Because the United States, they don't hide their money. They just ship it overseas, I think. And they...
That's not hiding it. Right. Or something.
I don't know what the Pandora Papers viewpoint of that was. That's
they don't illegally hide their money. They legally hide their money.
Yeah, they make the laws and stuff. So that's what you can do. You can be a lawmaker when you have lots of money.
I want to do this. And see if that kicks the viewer count up by one by putting the stream on my cell phone. Yeah, and Vitingale, Cenk brought that up. It's like it's just because it may not be ethical, it may be legal, but it may not be ethical, right? But that's okay. And I can't remember what the conversation was about. LM, Vitingale wants to know, what kind of tenant organization do you meet with?
They're fighting gentrification. In New York City, that's as much, that's as much as I'll say for right now. Keep watching over the weeks if you want to know more. But I don't know. I don't want to say too much about them, but they've been instrumental in seeing letting people's voices be heard, because the New York City Housing Authority, they don't listen to the tenants and they just make decisions top down. And all of the management offices, they're not ministerial in the sense that, you know, whenever a tenant, they rent paying or not rent paying, you know, if they're going through some rent hardship, either way, they get just cover up fixes for their apartment when they have serious matters, serious issues, you know, like asbestos, lead, mold, you know, things that have lifelong impact, you know, especially if you're raising a child, especially if, like, how are you supposed to have a pet even? Like,
really?
Yeah, so that's a little bit about the tenant organization.
Yeah, especially when they're like support animals or even if somebody has a, you know, some blind person, you know, has a dog to help with that. You know, it's like that's even like the most. Well, that's a dog. I mean, and then you start going into everybody else's animals. So it's like, well, they can have fish, but I can't have a ferret. Or I can't have a cat, or I can't have a bird, or I can't have a... It's like, geez. It's like, and you know, for and for like a studio apartment, you know, two people can't live there, and like, at least you have some kind of something you could consider companionship there, hanging out with you.
Yep.
That's if you're like lucky enough to be able to afford a studio apartment by yourself.
Yeah, and yeah, exactly. Like that assumes that you could work and all that stuff. And also, like, if you can't work, you know, the some organizing, you know, allies, friends, they talk about, you know, I told them that, you know, Social Security isn't all that secure, you know, like that's like every other public service, public good. It's under, you know, it's under legal scrutiny, financial attack. So, like, for example, like public transit here in New York City is funded by the Koch brothers or Koch brothers, whatever their names are, and everybody uses public transit. Like, a lot of people do, and I'm sure a lot more would. You know, they would love to be taken off the streets, and the roads are packed during, you know, during our rush hour. So, and you got people getting frustrated. The gas prices aren't coming back down to what they used to be. And, I don't know, you have to pay insurance costs ongoing. Gas prices aren't, like, you have to pay gas constantly. So these are reoccurring, you know, financial aspects that go on with the public, and the government is supposed to be serving the public, but instead they're taking money from the upper and from the upper class, which is getting less and less people, you know. And this reminds me about like walking, like when I take the train from work or to work and I go down to like Manhattan, like Midtown area, it's like, you know, I just suppose like a bunch of people there, like, I don't know, like they're well off, like, but I don't know if they see what's going on, like the company, like Amazon acquired Whole Foods, United Healthcare acquired this other company. They're gonna acquire Blue Cross Blue Shield, and like it's the centralization of capital, and you know the forming, the merging of companies into fewer and fewer companies. So that's the trend at hand, and you know, they call us the second Gilded Age that we're in, and I don't know so much what the first one was like. So,
only the Gilded get to know what the Gilded Age is like, I guess.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a part of what motivated the labor movement to fight for to fight with FDR, you know, to struggle against him. And you know, the upper class, the billionaire class, they got together and they said, well, I don't know if they had billionaires back then. Did they have billionaires? Or was it just like 10 millionaire, like they had like tens of millions of dollars or something at that time. Like, they're the ones that said, oh, the labor movement, you know, we need to give them concessions or else they're going to claim the whole system.
We have to give them a little bit, otherwise they'll take it all.
Yeah, exactly. And we have to,
we're giving them something.
They gave us the Public Housing Act of 1937, and you know that was written as a discretionary bill. So, or I think was it discretionary or non-discretionary? Sorry, I wrote it down on my minutes for today with a tenant org, but I'm making a meal right now, so it's a little bit, you know. I'm live in the struggle.
Well, you don't have a teleprompter like floating in like augmented reality. That's where that comes in, where you'll be able to like read stuff while you're like doing stuff. Take your office with you. Have a screen in front of you while you're working in the garden. While you're like looking at like, oh, what's this weed? What's this weed? What's that weed?
There's weed. Yeah.
I would build a gardening robot. Especially something that pulls weeds.
And one of my oh, I don't know. This, you know, we can go different ways. Like, do we? I don't know. Like, anyone in the audience want to steer us? Feel free to do so. Like,
I have a wheel, but
yeah, we can do.
We have a wheel. I have a wheel. Where's my wheel? I used to have a wheel. Oh, it's an add-on. it's this wheel. So I need to move this up a layer. No, I need to move.
Do we want to talk more about
this down a layer? There we go.
Do we want to talk more about weeds, or do we want to talk about like weeds in the garden? Because I heard that there could be some health benefits to that, and maybe probably. I don't know how informed we are on that. Like, and then there's also I think we could talk about like the Public Housing Act of 1937.
We can also talk about. I should actually mention real quick, Vitingale says, ha, 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 that's right. You better give us what's fair or we're coming for it. Collective bargaining works and they should be afraid of it because people organized are powerful. Yep. And, you know, a few weeks ago I saw the president of Teamsters give a speech in Philly. I think it was with Bernie was there. And he said that, you know, I think we're due for a general strike. You know, and actually, and they were talking about, you know, the Labor Day that just passed and that Labor Day was created by the government as a way to make it so May 1st didn't correspond with the European labor holiday or May Day, which is really, really interesting and, you know, social engineering and, you know, some early psyops, social engineering.
Like, Because then it would be a real international coalition. It would be a, it would be more than one mass movement. It would be multiple mass movements, and that's what the government doesn't want. But that's what, you know, that's what their neglectful, like utterly neglectful actions or inaction, I should say, you know, that's what it calls for. That's why we, you know, I don't know, like.
A general, a consumer and labor strike.
Yes, a consumer strike is important also because people don't know that they have power outside of the electoral realm. And when you take your dollar to a store, you take it to for example, Walmart. You take it to Costco. You take it to your local deli. You take it and give it to your church. Those are all consumer decisions. You're, you know, they're putting out something, and you're, you know, giving them something back for what they're putting out. So you could coordinate with others and you know, have collective action that way. You could have mass collective action. You could have local community action, you know, consumer, not just a boycott, but outright informed consumer decision-making. Like once you know about a university, for example, that you know, they keep expanding onto the local community's property and you know, displacing them, then you can decide, oh, once you find out about that, you know, which the university actively, they will usually try to bury that stuff, and you know, because they have money in their coffers and whatnot. And yet, at the same time, they raise the tuition prices, even though they have alumni funding and whatnot. And they have organizational partnerships. So,
yeah.
They have organizational partnerships.
Let me know how this audio is. I want to kind of get it in the background, but I have it not. It's like my audio is the weakest. I want to make sure that I'm not like it. So I'm like, actually, Vitengale may be able to help. I'm gonna do some searching, but when I was in the local guitar center, I noticed that they were selling used microphones, and I was like, that's a really cheap way to get an upgrade. And I have a Sennheiser and a Shure, but they're more like microphone. These are more like microphones that somebody at an auction would use. Sorry.
No worries.
It's like hard to tell what, maybe I should just look on eBay but I don't know. It's like what to look for is like the next step up or, you know, cause this is pretty directional and I'd like to have something that's maybe not so directional. With the general with the general strike at the in chat, I typed a few things. One was imagine neighborhoods collaborating for a week of general strikes and coordinating it with a freezer cleaning. Like everybody cleans out their freezer and cooks for each other in the neighborhood for a week while everybody else is doing a general strike.
Freezer cleaning, like I'm sure people have, like, you know, stuff that they'll, you know, they'll let go to waste and they don't need to do that, so they could just use stuff.
Yeah, and then at the end of the strike, everybody goes shopping, and now that they know what they need and what they don't need, and all the businesses are happy again.
If only, right?
Yeah, if only. Thanks for lurking. Enjoy your dinner. LM's having dinner. I'm going to have meds in about 15 minutes. Maybe I'll have a fudgesicle. I've been imbibing an apple flavored beverage and some smoking material. I guess the audio's okay. I haven't heard any complaints. Tweb? LM, no, yep, LM, yep. So one thing that's missing is I could put a Discord chat, you know, overlay in here someplace. That may be useful or not. I mean, I have two Discords open anyway, so, you know. And Nina's having dinner, and Vitingale's having dinner, and LM's cooking dinner.
I mean, I'm about to eat. I'm just waiting for it to cool down.
Everybody's having dinner. So I guess we'll have some dinner music. I'm gonna get a fudgesicle. Well, I'm gonna end up having some meds here in a minute. So. 15. Yep, that was really, you know, kids with guns. It's really a shame. And you know, I just have to mention, I'd also like to talk about Canada and their horrific and what I really don't get is how the guy could have killed himself while in custody. Okay. All right, so Nina's giving me a sound check. And yeah, I wish I could get my volume up. It's really a... I wonder if I just need a shorter cable. I don't know if I have a shorter XLR cable or not. I think I just need a better microphone. Or I need to like talk directly into the microphone, and then I can also. Oh, so if I turn down. Oh, I can't. Why can't I turn desktop audio down? That's what I don't understand. Do I have to do this? No, I don't think so. That's like a speaker volume, maybe. Input. US 122. Okay, that's all the way up. Applications. Those are all up as far as they can go. I can do. Oh, I can turn Google down. Echo. Who's echoing? Okay, so I'll wait for another sound check after the stream catches up. Because I think I can turn. Well, I think I just did turn down. Oh, I'm echoing. Crazy. Is the background music echoing? Is that no, that can't be it. No music. And I'm still echoing. The audio on this is just, it's like one step up from muted. Okay, that's, I think, as low as that can go. So it means I can leave this all the way up. Okay. Okay, let's see. I've got the stream running on my other machine. Oh, the timer went off. Let's see. All right. So now I know what you mean by echo. Okay. Some content. Yeah. Like an hour and 20 minutes. Oh, well. Okay, let's see what this is like. I don't think it's going to be any different, but maybe a little bit better. We'll see. It's an adjustment, at least.
Okay, let's see what this is like.
Okay.
I don't think it's going to be any different, but maybe a little bit better. We'll see. It's an adjustment, at least.
Still echoey. Hmm. And now I'm hearing my background. All right. Okay. It had to be coming over desktop audio somehow. Maybe this will help. Okay, let's see. I don't know. I'll listen with everybody else. Let's see what this sounds like.
Maybe this will help.
No, that didn't help at all. Man, I'm still. Hey, Biscuit. Oops. Biscuit's over in Farside Hangout. We could get the report from Denver Boulder if we bring him in.
Biscuit's over in Farside Hangout.
Hey there, Bird Eater. Can you hear me? Can you raise your hand? I'm having trouble hearing you.
We could get the report from Denver.
I can't hear anything.
Yeah, dude. Watch the stream. Yeah, the Twitch.
I'll go to your Twitch then, but I won't be able to.
Yeah, watch the stream. Yeah, Nina's there and LM's there and.
Oh, great. I'll go to your Twitch.
Right on.
Yeah, the Twitch. I'll be back.
And Vightingale's there. Okay.
Yeah, Nina's there and LM's there and.
Ooh. Oh, that's another place it could be coming from. Okay. All right. So now I think I've closed all the audio leaks that I know of. Yeah, we are, and we are still streaming. Yep. That still didn't help, Nina. No, I'm actually glad that you did say something. Otherwise, I would have had no clue whatsoever. Burnt butter biscuits. You should have told me that was you in TYT looking for a gifted sub, and I would have gifted you a sub. I asked him, what did I say? It depends on how biscuity you are. I'll. You need a sub. Yeah, but you're on the dole, dude. You can. Well, if you're not gonna sub to TYT, what are you gonna do here? No. Oh, we gotta try and save. We'll try and save a founder's badge for you somehow. I wonder if we can get Build Back Better funding for our streaming. I need to fix my trails out back. I need to put some drainage in. Can I get some Build Back Better funding for that? So I did the Youth Conservation Corps when I was 14? 15? Something like that? A PP loan? Oh, yeah. I was trying to think of how I could get, of course. I'll get you that. Yeah, what's up, LM? Yeah, can you hear me? he's not watching the stream. Yeah, we can hear you, but I'm trying to fix audio leaks, and this was one of them that I thought was leaky. It's a special effect. It's my new voice now, until it stops working. I need a BBB loan. Yeah. What was PPP? I mean, man, if you like contrived something, I just didn't think of, like, I don't think of money. I'm like weirdly unattached to money in a way, because I don't see a lot of it, and it's not that big of a deal. But you know, it's amazing what I could do with $2,000 a month. I could hire somebody to help me and still take on more than I could pay $2,000 a month. I could pay the taxes and all the bills and save for travel money and pay my car insurance and hire somebody to help me do chores around here. It's amazing. It's amazing how kind of like the scale of money I like to work on is just so minimal. And like, yeah. That's part of how recycling things and reuse a lot of reusing and a lot of scrap, and not so much scrapping as far as bringing metal for exchange for money, more or less reuse than scrap. There's a lot of potential. I just can't do it by myself. That's why I'm trying to like build up a few cabins to rent and a few campsites. Kind of hip camp / Airbnb, but more of a leaning more towards artists and people who want to like take on like free free room in exchange for a little bit of like a couple hours of work a day, you know, like, you know, I would like to like have a 4-hour work day, 4 days a week. Yep. That'd be it. Hang on a second. So we've got audio problems again. Because Bert said we lost components when you adjusted audio. And Biscuit says I just hear me talking to myself. Oh, you. Yeah, that's me. You is me, and oh, we can't hear LF. Okay, so to be more specific. Right, okay, so he comes from desktop audio. Okay, so you're right, I'm not hearing you. It's not hearing you. All right. Huh, so. Okay, that's on simultaneous. No, and then this should be. Simultaneous. Okay. Let's see if input is US 122. Okay, that should be good. All right. Okay, go ahead and start talking again, LM, and let's see if anybody can hear you. And kind of muffly, but all right. So we gotta wait for all right. Can we hear him? Oh, hang on a second. I got you muffled.
You can hear me. We're having trouble here.
Okay. Can you? All right. Yeah. Okay. All right. I'm muted. I'm muffled on Fireside Hangout. So. All right, so right, not yet. Okay, no LM yet. All right. No. What did I do? Okay, try that again, LM. It says tiny bit now. But now I'm echoing in my headphone. Oh. Output. No. Yeah. Still no LM. Well, no, it's my end. I mean, I hear you. Okay, no LM. Okay, try again. Ooh, wow. I'm up higher. Okay, I think I figured out how everybody was hearing you just a little bit, LM.
Let me see. Let me see if I can fix my settings here.
I don't know yet. I just know I'm echoing. How can I? All right. So if I tell. Okay, I gotta make that go away. And I need to make. sorry. That's background music. We don't want background music. We're getting it from the web page, but we're not hearing LM. He should be coming through on desktop audio, and I shouldn't, and I am, and that's wrong. That's why I'm echoed.
Damn.
Okay, where's advanced audio properties? Yeah, hang, they don't hear you. I mean, we do. I do, so it's kind of boring. Oh, we hear him there. Now? Still? What? Huh? Yeah? So I'm like, I have to deal with the delay. So I'm just, oops, what did I just do? Oh, when I held my headset to the mic. Okay, that doesn't count. Damn it. All right, so OBS's audio needs to be coming into, no, Discord's audio needs to come into OBS. So, Discord's output. Should be simultaneous output. Okay. So try saying something again, alum. Somebody's got to do it. Biscuit's having fun. Okay, still no LM question mark? Well, you still, either way. Before you assume that the adjustments don't work, you have to wait and check the chat. Right, yes. Good idea. Very delayed now. Now. Dude, let's see what now delay. 30 seconds? Congrats on the on Biscuit's wife alliance. Got a teaching job, teaching second grade. Finally, congratulations. A lot of delay. Yep, delay between chat and live is significant. Kind of like Moon talk. All right. Audio. What the heck's going on with the audio? All right. I may change some. The music is up, but let give it another go, LM. What did I just change? The background music audio level. Well, we still can't hear you. Oh, well, actually, you just... So it's delay. I don't know. How do you tell? It's just what it is. The delay. The delay between, so I actually have the ultimate way of determining. Give me a second. Okay. So, I will... Oh. Okay, we can go down here. Now, a second late. Okay. That was on the minute, so it's easy to keep track of. That's according to the atomic clock in Fort Collins, Colorado. On 15 megahertz, lower sideband. Okay, well, that at least tests the delay. And you can actually go back. Well, no, you couldn't. Anyway, yeah, well, look at the video. Yeah, anyway, look at the recording to figure it out. That'd be weird. All right, so let's get LM's audio back, or attempt that. Yeah, you sound better to me. Yep, hopefully, okay, that did me doubling. Oh, thank you. That's messed up. Oh, I can hear you through. Okay, hang on a second. Let's try. All right. Let's see if I can, because I should see your audio move the desktop audio level on OBS. So go ahead and say something. Just say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Well, that's an improvement. It's definitely trippy. Okay. I haven't seen anything. Well. Well. Uh-oh, I can't tell. Oh, yeah. Well. I wonder why it's looping your audio. I almost like want to I shouldn't have upgraded to. It's so freaking weird. What the hell's going on? Oh, okay. What is it? Okay. Okay. Well, that's a, okay. And then I just changed the desktop audio to use the first. Desktop audio. to use the first built-in analog stereo in the list of the of two built-in analog stereos. So, LMs. Oh, what? Okay, so LM. You still hear LM? Can you? I don't understand that, Nina. And he's looping, and we have 9 viewers. How so silly that nothing's working. Yeah, and that's like you're just. Well, your looping tip is LM. Okay. LM is looping for me. Should we just go over to like Fireside Hangout and then we can like have everybody here? Well, it'd only be Nina. I mean, well, no, we're in. No, it's a different chat. I forgot.
We've been streaming from there, so, and that's worked last time. It was pretty stable, so.
Yeah. And chat, what's going on, chat? Background music. All right, so desktop audio, it shouldn't be looping, it's still output. Everything's a monitor off, alerts are monitor and output. Oh, everybody's eating.
I'm not eating anymore.
No, everybody else is. That's why they're not chatting. I said, hello, chat. And nobody's saying nothing. Well, to everybody that's been eating. So usually, what I use in Discord is simultaneous output to analog stereo. And then I see you there, but you're not listening to the stream, and I'm not either. Actually, Actually, what I'm just going to do is... Oops. Okay, so we've got the music back. Let's just turn that off for a minute. Because I can't even hear myself. Okay, that's a pretty... Well, that's a pretty good response, though.
Okay, that's a pretty...
It's only like 5 second delay coming back at me.
All right, 5 seconds, we can work with that.
Yep. Oh, and I can hear you.
And we're back.
You're a little low. How can I get the audio level up then?
You're a little low. How can I get the audio
All right, let's try that. Go ahead, and I boosted your Discord audio.
Let's try that. Go ahead, and I boosted your...
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's not too bad. But I don't think it's really any different than what it used to be, what I had it at 100% instead of 200%. But go ahead and try it again. Go ahead and say a little bit of something else again.
Something else again.
Parts of that are better than other parts. But you're hearable, but your audio's kind of low, and not for some reason.
Test.
That's not bad. I'm kind of loud now, though.
That's not bad.
In relationship to you, I'm loud. All right, so let's go back to the to this. The this lo-fi beats. And go down to about there, maybe? Just we have a little bit of a background. I don't know. Let's see what that sounds like. Well, I should have taken requests before everybody started eating. Then I could have the appropriate restaurant music.
The appropriate
restaurant music. If you're eating Italian tonight. Really strong. Where did the... Oh, I think
Barkator, I think we should pick this up, like, over the weekend or something.
Over the weekend. Oh, it is 10 o'clock. It's a good time to call it quits, 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
It is, you know, you've got work in the morning, and... I'll be going to bed in about an hour anyway. That's old farts. Is this, let me try something here though, real quick.
And also, we could coordinate throughout the week as well, not just the weekend. Like,
right. Oh, here we go. That's really clear audio. Of course, it's only coming through the stream. Discord. That's a disadvantage of all of this. Let me try something here just for jiggles and giggles. Thank you.
All right, I'll talk to you later, Barkeeter. Have a good night.
All right, LM. I was just trying to bring Radio Habana up on the shortwave radio. And seeing how the audio, what the audio sounded like through through Twitch. One of the things I want to do is try and get the Radio Habana.
You want me to stay on 15 minutes?
You're kind of muffly.
You want me to stay on a little bit, like a little bit more?
Sure, if you can, if you want to. I mean, I'm not gonna. No, I'm not. I'm twisting anybody's arm. I'm just trying to find which frequency of I use this site. It's a short-wave.info, and there's a lot of presets that you can check out, and the one I check out is for Radio Habana. I'll try and hold down the echo. I'm at 11850 right now, and that's supposed to be a 250-watt station in Spanish. Here's, it ain't the best. Actually, this is a little bit better. That's Radio Habana. Alright, let me turn this. So go ahead, LM, if you could say something again. Let's see what I hear through the stream.
LM, from the Fireside
Commons. Your audio is mumbly through. We gotta get your audio quality up. If you want to stream, we gotta get your audio quality up.
I could use like a computer or
it could be just a Bluetooth headset.
Oh, wasn't it good on the first stream though?
In comparison? I don't know, we'd have to do a side by side comparison.
I'll look into it.
Well, I'm looking for used microphones too, so don't.
I'm going to have it from all the. My theory with you, Bark Eater, you know, even though we,
That's good.
A little bit of instrument.
That sounds good right there. Now it sounds like shit.
Huh. All right, we'll figure it out though. I'm gonna get going here. I'll talk to you later.
All right, LM buddy, thanks a lot. Thanks for playing. Have a good night. And and tomorrow's Friday, so work nice and slow.
I'm all right. All right, I'll see what I could do about that.
All right, don't sweat it.
Yeah. All right, talk to you later.
Okay, be well, buddy. Peace out. I'll sign out the Twitch here in a bit.
Cool. All right.
Maybe I'll do a musical departure or something. If I get a request, I mean the chat's kind of dead, so you know, I don't know. I could just play taps.
Oh, it's up to you, but I don't know.
Oh like yeah, people, but don't let that worry you. you do what you gotta do, and I'll do what I gotta do.
All right. Yeah, peace and love.
Yeah, peace out, brother.
Thank you.
Thanks, like I said, thanks for playing. All right, so we switch back to well, those don't make any much sense, do they? Yeah, we can do that. That kind of works, I guess. Yep. Let's make this a little bit smaller. Yep. Audio. But that made it stop. But whatever I did, it's all clean and everybody's working and I heard LM and we're good. So what was I? I was playing something. Oh, I was playing those solos. Everybody's seeing what my favorites are. My favorites are all there for everyone to see. Yeah, so what? Where is... No. No. Right. No. Oh, yeah, her. All right. Larissa Livier. I was playing I was playing along with her. Like time. All right. So, what key is Pink Floyd? Time in A major. So let's grab my A harmonic. A. It's an harmonic A. Sorry. All right. And it's only a little bit of time. It's a minute and 35 seconds exactly. All right, so. There you go. It is forever in. Oh no, it's only for 14 days, isn't it? I guess it could be clipped. A minute? You go minute clip, right? Can you go 2 minute clips? I can't remember. Anyway. That was fun. Oh yeah, oh yeah, she's much cuter than I am. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Anyway, yeah, I envy her wardrobe. It's very cute. She has a very cute wardrobe. And it's like she wears something different every time. Because I did a few of those from her. They were fun. Once I know the key, it's so easy on a harmonica. If you know the key, you can pretty much play anything and it doesn't sound terrible. at least it's in the same key. You can't go wrong, right? Yeah, it's not like a chromatic. Where is a chromatic harmonica is more like a piano, except that every note has a flat and a sharp. where that's not exactly, you know, because it's got a, you know, it doesn't exactly follow exactly the same rules as a piano. I don't see how it could, because everything. Well, chromatic harmonicas just have to have. They have four sets of reeds, two for in and two for out. And, you know, everything doesn't have a half step, so I don't know exactly how that works musically, and I really have no business talking about half steps and whole steps either, but all right. Well, with that musical finale, I thank everybody for lurking or listening or watching or doing what you're doing, and I'll probably just go right back to the Discord, over to the Fireside Hangout, and continue there. And thanks, LM, and, you know, thanks everybody for playing and playing technical support, and I think we finally got it. So peace out. And then I gotta click on this.